That's the first time in the history of DOA that we implemented such a system. So, yeah,
that's how does the break gauge work?
それはどういったシステムでしょうか。
そうですね、まあ、よくある格闘ゲームによくあるんですけどね、ゲージをたくさん貯めて、まあ、必殺技を打ちましょうという感じのものになっています。
So, just like many other, fighting games, it's a gauge where it gets charged, and then you unleash, you know, fatal attacks once it's filled.
And it also, gives you an opportunity to do defensive moves as well, also known as the break hold, and then of course the offensive move, which is known as theBreak blow. It gives you a really cool animation and gives you that really cool close up、yeah. of the hit that you saw in the trailer right there. So it gives you the opportunity to execute those moves.
So if you're getting like pressured a lot, you can use that as like a get out of jail free card.
Nah, I wouldn't call it that. I wouldn't call it that. It's very strategic. It has to be timed.
Sure.
And it's, as far as a defensive tool, it's not very, damaging. So it's just、okay. kind of to build that space a little bit. But again, it could be used offensively as well.And give you that cool animation that people have been seeing during the trailer.
Okay.、Mm. Yeah. Does the system return in terms of strikes beat throws and throws beat holds, holds beat strikes, which has been a staple in the series? Is that returning as well? Is it the same way?
その三組の仕組みは基本的に前作と同じです、ね。
あの前作と基本的には同じで、もうデッドライブの伝統ですからそこは守っていきます。
Yeah,、that's what defines Dead or Alive. So yeah, they're the same.
Nice. And I know one of the staples of Dead or Alive too is.We like the way the characters look in terms of the different outfits they have. So can we expect alternate costumes and maybe DLC costumes in the future to change our appearance and how we look?
デフォーコースが随分違うように見えるんですけども、mm-hmm. ということはゲーム内で様々なコスチュームがあることに期待してもいいですか、mm-hmm. まあ、あるいは DLC で様々なコスチュームに期待していいですか、
あのね、DLC のことはまだあんまり考えてないです。ごめんなさい。Mm-hmm. で、もちろんいろんなコスチューム入れますし、まあ、なんか皆さん結構心配してる方もいるんではっきり言っちゃうとカスビのいつものコスチュームも中に入ってます、mm. 青いやつね、mm.
So okay, well we really haven't gotten that ahead so we don't know what we're going to do with DLC per se but what we can say for sure is that you know, we've noticed that some players have been really worrying about you know, what if Kasumi'sDefault costume, the iconic blue outfit is still available. Yes, it is available in the game.
Okay.
That is for sure.
Nice. And when we have these different costumes, I was reading different details in this. I just want to make sure it was clear is that one thing that Dead or Alive has had in its progression in the series is sometimes there are overtones of sexuality and the way that people are displayed in the game, especially in women. And I'm wondering, I've heard changes taking place with that to move in a different direction to.Maybe expand to a broader audience to do things, but consider it the right way. Is that happening in this game?
その今までは、割りかとセクシーなトレンドできたんですけれども、話によれば、今回はもっとこうシリアスにちょっと違う方向へ向かって、より多くのファンを取り込みたいというふうに聞いてますけれども、それは事実ですか？
なんかちょっと誤解されているところもあるんですけど、まずね、はっきり言うと、全くこう揺れをなくすみたいな話が出てるんですけど、うん、そうじゃないです。デッドライブの伝統はやっぱり守りたいし、うん、遺伝子ですよね、うん、そこを消すつもりは全くありません。 だけどちょっとやりすぎてたところがあるんで、うん、そのやりすぎてたところをトーンダウンしていきたいなっていうのが本音です、
うん、Yeah, we got a lot of comments about, you know, the jiggle and the bounce.
I like what you use the actual words, yes.
But to be honest with you, it, you know, that is something innate, and that's, you know, part of the gene of the DOA series. So it's not gone entirely, but we've taken such approach where it is just more realistic and natural, just so he just wanted to clear that it's
sure.
it's not how people think of it.
Just toned down.
Toned down.
Right, so it's not like all over the place and distracting.
Yeah, it's right. Realistic. It follows with, you know, a fighting sense and how the costumes are set together. So.
Sure.
そもそもこのゲーム、今回激闘エンターテインメントってコンセプトで、本当にこう激闘してるところを描きたいということなんですよ。男も女も関係なく殴り合ってるんですね。で傷も作りますし、顔も汚れて、うんまあ、結構今まで作れなかった絵を一生懸命作ってます。うん。
Okay, so the core concept of this game is, you know, intense fighting entertainment.
Yeah.
So in that, we brought a lot of new elements into this game, such as, you know, just sweating, getting wounded, getting dirty,
and
distorted facial. A distorted face.
Oh, like scars and stuff like that, maybe.
Yeah.
So the further you go along, the more you get beat up, the more the battle damage is shown on.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
And he's got more to say.
まだ言いたいことないけどさ。でね、そういう意味でも、キャラクターもそうだし、その背景に関しても全て、より自然に見せたいって思ってるんですね。だから、オーバーすぎる表現よりも、今はその自然な表現っていうのを目指しています。
Okay, so in that sense, you know, even the background and the characters themselves have to look more natural.
Sure.
More natural. That is important to this game. So no more exaggerated, you know, expressions and presentations.
Okay.
And on top of that, during some of the gameplay, you also noted that even the clothes will also kind of rip apart and show the scratches as well.
Yeah.
And not only just the sweat, but the grime of the fight will kind of spill over because they're so hot, sweaty, and they're on the floor, so they're just getting dirty. Right. Of course, if you're untouched, you'll look very clean.
Right, exactly. Which makes you look better, right? Your opponent's all messed up and you're like, what's the matter?
Yeah, exactly.
So let's talk fighting games in that sense. This has been a big, like, past 3 years for fighting games. The scene's growing tremendously, and now with Dead or Alive 6 here, I have to wonder, are there elements in place to make sure that you can stay competitive, such as frame data in training mode, maybe showing hitboxes and hurtboxes as you're training, or how deep does training go to make sure you can stay at the top of the game and be competitive?
そのヒットボックスとか、フレームボックスとか、そういった、そういったトレーニング向けの仕組み、要はそのコンペタティブを意識した仕組みは、に関する作りはどうなってますか？
そうだな、どこまでやろうかな、今回。まだね、実は考えてないんですよね。
How far will I go? I haven't really thought
about it. あのね、やりすぎるとね、実はゲームの寿命縮んじゃうんですよ。なので、今までやってきたサービスは当然やっていきます。で、それ以上やるかどうかはちょっと検討させてください。
So, well, it is my belief that if we do it excessively, it actually shortens the life cycle of the product. But so, you know, all I can say at this point is people, our fans can expect what they're familiar with, but how much farther would I take it? That's to be determined.
Okay. But each character has different fighting styles, and you can play each character differently. So if you and I were playing the same character, if people knew our fighting styles and the way we play, but they didn't see us, they could tell which one of us over a history, like that's gotta be his character. That's the way he plays.
Right, and I think it illustrates really well. I think that our life has always done a really good job of doing that. So anybody that's very intuitive with the game and is essentially a top or professional player, you can tell right away, I know that fighting style. I know who that is. That's, you know, Shinbori-san, or that's Master. I know who's playing that character.
The ones who are looking for the hard counters all the time, and maybe it doesn't work out, but when they do, you're like, oh man, that was so good.
Exactly, it's well illustrated.
Nice. And online play, I'm guessing, is still an element and done in certain fashions. Maybe it's like a tournament mode or a team play mode or just regular mode?
オンラインモードはどういった仕
様？オンラインモードね、今回その細かいモードよりもどっちかっていうと、ラグを取る方にちょっと専念しています、オンラインのチームは。
So this time around, instead of, you know, just implementing various different modes, our biggest challenge right ahead of us is to reduce the lags and the
nice.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
今ね、多分プログラマー見てるかもしれないからね、ちょっと頑張れって言っておきますね。
I think many of our programmers are watching this, so I'm just telling them, hey, do your job.
Well, you know what? You guys are doing a great job too. I think a lot of fighting game fans, especially fans of Dead or Alive series.